Hello Cancer, welcome to my channel Surbhi. This is the reading for second half of April for Cancerians. I've already laid down my cards just to save time. So Cancerians, these are all connective energies and these may be your energies or maybe the energies of the person you are dealing with. So please feel free to swap the characters as the energies resonate with you, and maybe even it is possible that they are mixed energies, or maybe they are entirely your readings or of your partners or a mix of both or the situation in which you are in. So basically what I see here, Cancerians, it is that you are fretting over certain issue which is giving you sleepless nights. You are not able to sleep at all at night. Just see, there is a fighting situation over here which you can see just below the pillow on which you rest. So whenever you try to sleep, you have that particular situation which is giving you a lot of anxiety and a lot of tension, and you are a lot of anguish. You are not just able to sleep because of this situation, whatever situation you are in. So you are guided by the Queen of Wands and the High Priestess to just let it go and enact. Sometimes the best action is not to take any action. The advice is, in such a situation, you just try to keep quiet, do not take any action, just meditate, just do your self-healing, be guarded. Whenever I see this card, I always focus my attention on this. Somehow I am always drawn to this cat. So be guarded. You will be able to get your inner strength. You will be able to get your inner strength. Just sometimes what happens is, whenever you try to solve a problem, you are not able to solve a problem in the routine practical ways. But if you try to cool down, if you try to meditate, if you try to leave the situation as it is, you are able to find certain solutions to the problem which normally you don't even think of. And you even get more signs from the universe how to solve this problem if your mind is at rest. If your mind is not at rest, you will not be able to solve the problem, whatever the problem is. So there is a certain situation. If it is a love relationship, maybe it is because of your partner. If it is a work place, maybe it is because of that, or maybe it is because of your friend or your relatives or whatever it is. But the only thing here is that you are being guided to guard yourself and be intuitive, be in touch with your inner guidance or your inner self, and you will be, and see, you are waiting. Maybe you are waiting for something. Maybe that is the cause of your anxiety. That is also a possibility, because we have the Three of Wands and the Two of Wands, which means that you have everything is ready with you, and you just don't know which direction to go, or you are not able to move forward with this knowledge or wisdom or the relationship or the situation in which you are. You are just not ready to, either you are not ready to move forward or you are not able to move forward, and maybe that is the cause of your anxiety. You are just waiting over here. In both the situations you are waiting. So what I think is, you are not, this is the cause of your anxiety. You are not able to move forward in a particular situation. You have a back turned towards this, and you are seeing at your ships. You are not able to move forward. Everywhere you are just keeping quiet. What I understand is, this is the cause of your anxiety. If it is a relationship, maybe then you are not move forward. You are not able to move forward with the relationship because of any issues which are causing you a lot of anxiety. Maybe the other person is not ready, you are not able to speak up, or if you have offered, then the other person is not ready to accept your proposal, or maybe it is because of the people in your vicinity or friends or relatives. But something is holding you back and you are not able to move forward, and I think that is the cause of your anxiety. You should just let it go, just give it time, meditate in the meantime, and just let things unfold gradually. Because you have the Ten of Pentacles, you have a happy family life over here. You are having an elderly person over here, you are having pets, you are having children, you are having a family, you are having a happy house. So what I understand is, and you have an Emperor card. Maybe this, whatever the problem is, this can be because of this Emperor kind energy, which is a very dominating, authoritative But it is a very justified energy. You cannot, this person is not a partial person. But yes, the negative point is authoritative, dominating. That can be the possibility. That is also, maybe that is also leading you, that is also the reason of your not being able to move forward, which is leading to anguish. This is also one possibility. But since you have the Ten of Pentacles in the reading, what I think is, you can have peace and a happy family if you just let the situation unfold itself gradually. Let me see what the spirit guides have to say. The Nine of Action. You have worked hard to create the things you cherish in your life, just such as beloved relationships, amazing accomplishments, and hearth and home. Rest assured that all these treasures and you are being constantly protected by your angels. In return, Mother Earth and the animals, the environment need your protection. Six of Abundance. Heaven opens its lovely, loving arms and pours abundance onto you. An unexpected gift is on the way. Accept it with gratitude and humility, knowing that you'll have a chance to return the generosity by giving to others in future. Consider volunteering for a charitable organization. So basically, whatever it is, see, you have three authoritative cards in this. This is another perspective to the reading, that you have three authoritative cards in the reading, which is the Queen of Wands, the High Priestess, and the Emperor. All of them are authoritative. So maybe you have built yourself to this position after a lot of hard work. Pentacles also mean hard work. So maybe you have built yourself up after, you have built a happy family life after a lot of hard work, and you are in a position of authority, but you are not able to move forward in a certain field or in a certain relationship. But again, the High Priestess is guiding you, and even the Six of Abundance is guiding you for the fact that if you let it unfold itself, then the universe will give you the clues, the universe will offer you the gift, which you will be able to accept and nurture, and that will be good for you. See, the Nine of Action and the Ten of Pentacles. So you do have happiness. You do have happiness. It is not that you don't have happiness. You do have happiness. All the cards are positive. Only thing is, there is a little bit of waiting over here, and which is causing you anguish. Whatever the situation in which you are, just rest assured that the outcome is positive. And the only thing you need to do is just keep quiet, give it time, and let it unfold gradually. That is the only thing which you have to do, Cancerians. There is no option with you. The more you try to solve it by this way or the other way, maybe it will not even work out, because you have to just, this person is also waiting for what? Just thinking something, what is right, what is wrong, what to do, what not to do. So everything is interlinked in this, that you have to just trust your instincts, meditate, trust your instincts. Whatever the universe has to offer, or which comes naturally to you, will be the best for you. You have to trust the universe for whatever is happening in your life, and it will be good for you. That's all I have for you, Cancerians. And if this reading resonates with you, it is good. And if it does not resonate with you, then please check your moon sign and the Venus sign. Thank you, and please subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Thank you.